Hi there, my name is Dr. George Murphy. I'm an assistant professor in medicine in the Division of Hematology Oncology at the Boston University School of Medicine. And I'm also one of the co-directors of the Boston University and Boston Medical Center's Center for Regenerative Medicine, which we affectionately refer to as the CREM. Basically, we're a bunch of sort of like-minded researchers that are interested in all things stem cell biology and regenerative medicine related. More specifically, what I do in my group does is we're very interested in understanding exactly how blood cells form in the human body, and even more specifically, maybe when this process goes wrong, what actually happens, such as in diseases like sickle cell anemia, where red blood cells form improperly and then leading to all sorts of negative downstream consequences in many different organ systems. And we generally explore these areas of research using really cool stem cell-based models, viruses and vectors that allow us to insert genes into cells themselves, and other really sort of high-tech cell and tissue culture-based systems that really allow us to explore and investigate all these questions that we have. Around when I was in maybe the fourth grade, I came down with a mysterious illness that seemingly nobody could decipher. So during that time, after about 2 years, they diagnosed me with a non-specific autoimmune disorder. But perhaps more impactfully for me, what I really realized during that time was really how little we knew about the human body. And perhaps even more importantly, that this lack of knowledge was directly related to the degree of human suffering that I saw all around me in the hospital during that time. So that's when I started to formulate the possibility that maybe I could have a career in science and medicine and really begin to maybe help to unravel some of these unknowns to maybe one day be able to ease some of the suffering that I saw during that time period of my life. Some of the things that we're actually doing right now today, those stem cells that I told you about, those pluripotent stem cells that can become any tissue type, we have the ability to specify them into many different cell types that are found within the body. And what we're doing right now is something we refer to as the clinical trial in a test tube, or CT3 for short. And what this allows us to do is we can also make these specialized stem cells from patients with various genetic illnesses. And we can then take those stem cells and specify them into the tissue type that may be affected in that particular disease. Much in the same way, as you're going through that process of specification to these cells, we can actually investigate the disease processes that develop during that process of development. And at the same time, this process of the clinical trial in the test tube allows us to test maybe novel therapeutics or novel treatments in the exact genetic context of these patients. So in essence, what we can create are patients or subjects that are actually in a dish that may have a particular illness or disease and model that particular illness and disease, and at the same time, perhaps develop drugs that could actually be used to intercede in the process of that disease development. And that's something we're actually doing right now. In the future, one of the things that my group is working on is the possibility. So we make blood cells. We like to actually figure out exactly how blood cells form in the body. We can actually recapitulate this in the laboratory. So we can actually go from one of these stem cells into large numbers of, say, red blood cells or platelets. So one of our sort of Apollo mission projects is to be able to actually create clinically relevant, significant numbers of blood cells in the laboratory to obviate the need for blood cell donation. So we could actually make, theoretically, an unlimited supply of blood without issues related to contamination or supply. For example, there's a huge dearth of available blood in the third world. Wouldn't it be great if we could actually make an unlimited supply of blood products in the laboratory that could then be used for these types of applications? So that's one of our long-term downstream goals. I come from a pretty tough, underprivileged background, and I think many of the kids today that are in those same circumstances think that a career in science or technologies or in mathematics is really not something that's reachable or attainable for them. And I am an example that is actually not the case. And in my estimation, hardship fosters greatness. So what I would say to a kid or a student who's sort of in this type of situation, who doesn't think that these things are accessible, is that the one thing you should think about is maybe those things are even more accessible to you because you're battle tested. You've experienced things that are far more drastic and harder to cope with than maybe your experiment not working that day. So maybe you're tougher. Maybe you're perfectly suited for that type of career.